on the garbage.
Yeah.
On the garbage. And then up here.
Come back a little bit later on.
Hi, thank you for keeping New York City alive.
Thank you.
You know what I'm doing?
Yep.
Here I am, man.
Been all over, right?
Yeah.
See what happens here if you don't pick the straps up? They wrap around here. And then at the end of the day, he has to cut them all off.
You have that every night, right?
Spend more time taking it off than you do cleaning.
These are really heavy, strong things. They all wrap around and around and around.
See this stuff here, see?
Everything wraps around the...
So you got the rope there and everything, so that's what basically what...
You have to cut all that stuff off every night, right?
Every night. That's basically why we're out here, to help him sweep the streets and take up all the big stuff.
So it's all this hand... In the 20th century, we're still dealing with all this, like, hand...
Back in
individual
the
19th. Pieces
right.
of stuff picking
right.
up, right?
Yeah, it's been a good winter.
Yeah,
Why not?
Thank you. Thank you for keeping New York
Thank you for helping us. We need a lot of help.
I think so.
Yeah, I think so.
I wish there were 1,000 people standing with me right now.
Well, they're here, but they're not with you.
They're the peekers, right, man?
Yeah,
they're watching
right.
You from behind the curtain.
Oh, yeah, they love to watch us.
Huh?
They love to watch us. Watch this. Yes, you can. Thank you for what you do for us.
Thank
appreciate
you.
It.
My pleasure. I wish there were 1,000 people.
One
right
in a million.
There.
One in a million.
Thank you.
Thank you. You know what I'm doing?
Yes, I bet you're honest.
You
very
did?
Nice. Very
you
nice.
Did?
I appreciate
great.
That.
Great.
We all do, as a matter
great.
Of fact. Yeah.
So fast. See how much it takes both of those kids. Woo wee!
Maybe 5 years when you burn yourself out.
Yeah,
that's as far as you go.
Garbage don't get picked up. They don't worry about when it's 95 and you're still picking the garbage up. They don't worry about when it's snowing and raining on your back. You get arthritis on this job. They
well,
don't
that's
care about
right.
that.
See,
all they want you to do is put it on. Get the work done. That's all they worry about.
Every time I see a sandman, I'm gonna wave. And I'm going to try to shake hands with every sanitation man in New York City. You know how many there are? 8,500. It's going to take me 6 months to shake hands with everybody. And you want to be in this thing too with me? Will you wave every time you see a sandman and say thank you? Because they're trying to help keep the city clean, right? Will you wave at them and make them feel good about their work? And will you tell your friends about it? Then you'll be, it's going to be in the newspapers and everything. Okay? Will you think about it? Or say hi. If you don't want to wave, would you say hi to them? Just make them feel good because they're taking away your garbage. It's not their garbage. Wave at them, okay?
In a machine, if any garbage was I'll go get my broom, I'll sweep it up, put it in the garbage.
You're a very nice person. You're nice. You're helping. You help keep the city alive like that. You know that? Will you wave? Will you wave at them? What's the name of this thing? What's it called? Do you remember? Touch Sanitation.
Touch Sanitation.
Right. Okay? See ya, bye.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Hello.
They're following down to the floor.
Like sanitation, man. The bag is all full like that.
If you leave it here,
if you leave it there, they blame it on you.
They'll say, well, the sanitation man just went by. Look what he did. He left the bag that's all busted.
Yeah. See? Now, you wasted time picking this all up. The foreman says, well, how come you wasted so much time on the block? Tom, well, we got to pick up the spillage. Okay? And it's still not properly done right. If you want to do it right, you got to kill another couple of minutes here. Watch yourself.
Maggots. See all the maggots in there?
Where? Oh!
It comes from the garbage, from rotten meat and everything. Maggots.
I heard somebody call them walking rice.
A lot of hazards on this job. About the maggots.
That's another part of the job, right?
Now here's a metal bed. Now we can't take this here because we're going to Hamilton Avenue, which is an incinerator. And metal doesn't burn. But the public says, well, how come you can't take this here? And you try to explain it to them. You know, there's a very lot of lack of communications between the public and the sanitation man. Right? Now, how many times have they told you, hon, what was the reason behind it?
The men are supposed to take any kind of metal off.
Very good. Here's a very good point. Here's a very good lack of communication. The supervisor told the lady that they could take this here. In turn, they tell us we can't take nothing but burnable material. Now, how do you figure it? Right?
Appreciate your support there. Take care. Have a good day.
To lifting and loading, right?
Right.
What's it about? Like the swing
legs,
thing?
Legs and, you know, twisting movements.
Yeah.
Right. Everything. You have to be smooth. It's like anything else, you know?
You're very smooth.
All your motions have to be fluid, especially when you're working with weights, you know? Be fluid all the time.
Like you're real lanky, right? But you're strong.
You try to use your back, especially like that. Can we have before you try to use your back on that? Next thing you know, you got a slip disc, or your back is all fouled up.
So you got to run into
this way,
stuff.
Right? Stay, you know, move with it.
Men there are in New York City? Guess. How many?
What?
20? More. You know how many there are?
100.
More.
Couple thousand.
You're right, there are about 8,500. You know how much garbage we make in New York every day? 22,000 tons every day. People don't understand how hard their work is and everything.
Just because they're garbage men?
You know, they feel like people put them down because they work with the garbage, but really they're people like you and me, right?
Right.
So I'm trying to get people to wave at them, say thank you, and be careful.
Thanks.
Did you do it? Will you tell your friends? Would you wave at them now? Here, I'll hold your little ball, okay? Would you wave? Thanks.
Thank you. I was picking up a bag with a friend of mine, and as I was throwing it in the truck, the bag went over my wrist and slit my wrist.
Because it was glass?
Right, because there was glass. There was too much in the bag. The bag was compact too much. There was about 125 pounds in the bag, and it's uncalled for, 125 pounds in the bag. To put like 50 pounds,
you know? Like all that heavy weight?
Sure, it was laying on my arm. It was laying on my arm. When I went to pull my arm out, I cut myself.
Could have slit your whole wrist
off. Definitely.
Right?
Could have cut my whole wrist off. But I didn't watch it.
Yes,
you
yeah,
did.
Now I'm in 31.
Oh, 31?
Yeah. Okay. How you doing? Busy. Yeah. Just like to say that there's, you know, not enough people like you around. That's why things are so bad. Everybody likes to talk and nobody likes to do. Take care.
get the 92 first, all right? Pull the clip.
One of my men over there.
All right, Martha to the tower.
Going to Martha, Cap.
Yeah, we have these two in tandem here now. What do you want? You want to go up and grab another light one or whatever?
10-4, Cap. Push them two around security 86 against the dock, and the 53 you'll be putting in for yourself to take out.
Yeah, all right. Very good.
3-7-7-32.
Okay, right now the men are getting this empty barge that was just dug, and they have to bring in a loaded barge. It gets very dangerous at time because these cables could snap When you go to grab it, sometimes there's a burr in the cable that'll stick in your hand, so they have to be very careful. Each man knows his job. Each man knows what the next man is going to do. As the boat hits, a couple of men will jump off, a couple of men will stay on, and each guy will go to their next position. See, now during the nice warm weather, the men could walk up and down on the barges, you know, they could walk freely, but in the winter time when it's iced, they have to hold on, they need life jackets, it gets quite hairy. We've had quite a few men fall overboard that we had to stop operations to fish them out. So thank God we haven't had any serious accidents out here, but there has been a case where we did lose one of our fellow men out at, I think it was Pier 59. See, them cables are quite heavy. There's a big strain on these cables. See, the men have a line with a hook because they can't reach down with their hands, so they'll use the line with the hook on it around the cable and then bring the cable up over the bit. Now they have complete control of the loaded barge. Now the main job is to get rid of the light barge and then hook the loaded barge up so the engineer could go to work.
Two pedals and two knee buttons.
You got four things going on?
Six.
You're doing six?
Yeah, I got two here too.
Time?
Right. That's talent, right?